Morning, students. Come on, exciting, beta. Special cases of your YDSE. Special cases of YDSE. First one. Case number one. When source is at infinity. When source is at infinity. And source is at infinity and light is incident obliquely above the axis. You shouldn't. This one is your YDSE. Okay, and this one is your axis. Okay, this is the source of your S1, this is the source of your S2. Okay. Ray of light is being incident on this one. What is the condition? Source is at infinity and light is incident obliquely above the axis. And the axis manaku. This one is your axis. On this one, the ray of light is being incident at an angle like this. So it is making an angle of your alpha. This angle is nothing but alpha. Adhe vidhanga, one more ray on this one like this. The other ray of light on this one like this. These angles are making an angle of your alpha with your axis, above the axis part affiliation. Okay, now The distance between the slits is how much right now? The distance between the slits is nothing but of your small d. Okay, and this distance is right now for me capital D. This is a central point, maxima vo, isn't it? Now from this one, if I'm writing the slits right now for the given condition, the ray of light from this one will incident on this one. And so another ray of light from this one will incident on this one. So the point P where we may get the maxima or minima, that is at a distance of your y. Okay, now drop a path difference right now from this part. By the time this wavelet has been coming to the S1, the other wavelets are still in your air. So join all the wavelets of that one. So we'll try to get a straight line like this. This is a wavefront, which is making an angle right now. This is making an angle right now. This angle is nothing but equal to your alpha. This one is alpha kabatti right now. This one is alpha, so this one is also D. If I resolve this D into the components beta, so this will become for me D cos and this will become for me D sine. Now see this one, I'm writing here. This one is D. This one is right now like this. And this is your path difference. Idochesi manaku S1, idochesi manaku S2. This one is of a distance D. This one is nothing but of your alpha. If you resolve that D into your components right now, this side it will become for me D cos alpha and this side this will become for me D into your sin alpha. Okay, now the ray of light is coming somewhere from, say for example, A. This is your S2, this is your S1 and that one is of your SP part of relation. Now tell me the path difference beta. Can anyone tell me how do you draw the path difference? Path difference at point P will be equal to your how much? Path difference between rays at point P is, can anyone tell me? Delta X is equals to larger distance, which is a larger distance, A into S2 plus of your S2P, right? Chana nitla A into S2P minus this one will give me your S1P. Can I write like this? Or else I can write even this one as something like, this is nothing but of your A into your S2 plus, this will become for me S2P minus of your S1. Okay now, as small d is very, very lesser than of your capital D, we know that S2P minus S1P is equals to your, how much for me, your D into your sine theta, that is approximated to your D into your tan theta, I already told you. Therefore, S2P minus S1P will be equal to D. Tan theta will be equal to how much from the figure? Y by D. Anagada. So therefore, path difference will become for me, delta X is equals to A into S2 is how much C from the given figure? This one is A into S2. This one is here A into S2. This A into S2 is equals to how much for me? D into sine alpha. So A into S2 I can write as of what for me? D into sine alpha. So this one is D into sine alpha. Plus S2P minus S1P is nothing but for me y into small d divided by capital D. So this is your path difference when the ray of light is obliquely falling on the ray part of relation. When the ray and the source is at infinity and the light is incident obliquely above the axis, then the path difference is calculated by the formula delta X is equals to D into sine alpha plus y into small d by capital D. Now this value, the point P can be the maxima or minima beta. That depends upon the given condition, isn't it? Like say for example, if I'm taking the relation, delta X is equals to, for maxima if I'm talking about, for maxima, delta X will be equal to how much beta? Plus or minus N into your lambda. That means I can write this one as a fever. Plus or minus N into lambda means D into your sine alpha plus Y into small d by capital D is equals to N into your lambda. So from this one, I can calculate the different conditions, whatever he might be asking in the given problem for the given condition. In the same way, if I'm talking about for minima, delta X is equals to much better. Delta X is equals to plus or minus of your 2N minus 1 into lambda by 2. So therefore, I'll write right now for this one. D into sine alpha plus Y into capital D is equals to 2N minus 1 into lambda by 2. So this will be your path difference. isn't it? So I hope this case is clear for everyone. Very important case beta right now. When source is at your infinity, when the source is at your infinity part of relation, and the ray of light has been incident obliquely above the axis, then how do you calculate the path difference? Path difference is delta x is equal to a into s2p minus s1p. That means a into s2p plus s2p minus s1p. A into s2 is nothing but how much from the given figure you see? This one is nothing but equal to this one. So it is d into sine alpha, and s2p minus s1p already you know from the YDSC experiment. That is equal to how much for me? Y into small d by your capital D part of relation. Clear for everyone? Okay, na? Sure. Let us try to go for the next case. Case number 2. Case number 2. Condition is, when source is again at infinity, now you can tell me this one better. When source is at infinity, when source is at infinity and light is incident obliquely below the axis, same condition like a previous case. Okay, let me draw the diagram right now for this one again. So I'm taking the slit right now for this one like this. Yeah, and one more slit right now like this. Okay, and these are the two sources. Okay, and this one is your S1, and this one is your S2. This one is your central maxima. Okay. So this one is your O. So this one is your central axis. Okay. The ray of light right now is incident from the below right now. That means like this. The ray of light has been incident at an angle like this. This is the ray of light which has been incident. That means with this one it is making an angle of alpha. Another ray of light like this. Another ray of light like this. Isn't it? So by the time this reaches the S2, this ray of light is still in air. This ray of light is still in the air. So if I attach all that ray of light, this will form for me a path difference. So this path difference will form an angle right now here. This angle is nothing but equal to again alpha. Isn't it? Distance between S1 and S2 is nothing but how much for me? Small d. If I resolve this one, this is cos theta, and that will become for me sine theta part. So this is S2. This one is, say for example, some A. This point I'll take it as of your B. Ray of light from this one will be right now incident, so it will slightly bend and it will incident somewhere here. This is a point P. This ray of light will also go right now here and incident it is somewhere at a point P. From the central, it is at a distance of, say for example, Y. This distance is, say for example, of your capital D. Okay, now resolve the value of your small d beta. Now if I'm resolving the value of your small d part of relation, so this is your D and this one is right now here. This is making an angle alpha, and this one is right now for me B and S1. So this is D, means this will become for me D into cos alpha. So obviously this will become for me D into your sine alpha. Okay, na? Now what is the path difference between this one? Can anyone tell me the path difference beta? So path difference for this one is right now how much? Path difference, larger distance minus smaller distance. Path difference at point P. Okay, which is the larger distance? B, isn't it? That means delta x is equals to B to your S1 plus of your, this one is S1P minus this one is S2P. So I can write this one as of your, if I simplify this given, if I open the bracket, so this can be written as of your S2P minus of your S1P, isn't it? Minus B into S1. Can I write like this? So this is your delta x. Isn't it? Again, small d is very, very lesser than capital D. So S2P minus S1P is equals to actually D into sine theta. As theta is very, very small, so that will be equal to D into tan theta. So that will be equal to D into tan theta is nothing but Y by D. That means S2P minus S1P is equals to your D into your sine theta.
So minus delta X.
No. So now S2P will be equal to how much beta? So this one is delta X will be equal to S2P minus S1P. S2P minus S1P minus B into your S1P. So D is very, very lesser than. So this will become for me D into Y divided by capital D minus D into S1 is how much beta? D into your S1. B S1 is given as of your how much you see? B into your S1 is nothing but this one. It is nothing but D into sine alpha. So I can write this one as of your D into your sine of your alpha. Isn't it? So this will be your path difference for us. Clear for everyone? So when the ray of light is been falling from the down, when the ray of lights have been falling from the down part of relation, delta X is equals to D into Y by capital D minus D into your sine alpha. In the same way, I can use this one for your maxima or for your minima particulation. If I'm talking about for maxima, delta X will be equal to your how much? Plus or minus of your n into lambda. For minima, if I'm using again right now, for minima, delta X is equals to plus or minus of your, how much will be greater? 2n minus 1 into your lambda by 2. That will be giving the condition. Once you know the values, you can substitute and simplify for the given condition. That will give me the answer for the case. Clear for everyone? Chal. Adamain the ekkad varako. These two cases are clear for everyone, beta. When source is at your infinite distance or infinite and light is being incident obliquely below the axis. Obliquely below the axis, then path difference will be equal to how much? D into Y by capital D minus D into your sine alpha. Clear for everyone? అర్థమైందా లేదా నో రెస్పాన్స్
క్లియర్ సార్
సో వాట్ వి గాట్ టూ కేసెస్ వెన్ ఇట్ ఇస్ రే ఆఫ్ లైట్ హస్ కమ్ అప్పర్ అండ్ యాస్ వెల్ యాస్ ఆఫ్ లోవర్ ఎస్సి వర్మల దీనిపైన మంచి క్వశ్చన్స్ ఉన్నాయి నాన్న 2-3 స్లిట్స్ చేసి అవి ఒకసారి ట్రై చేస్తూ ఉండండి మీరు రాకపోతే ప్లీజ్ లెట్ మీ నో ఐల్ ట్రై టు హెల్ప్ యు అవుట్ ఫర్ దట్ సో లెట్ us try to go for the next one that is nothing but of your case number 3 Case number 3 is right now. If screen, very important, beta. This one is very important. If screen is placed, perpendicular to line joining two slits. And again, small d is very, very lesser than of your capital D. Then what is the path difference? Then path difference is how much? I'll show you the diagram. See, like this. This is some screen. And this is your source somewhere here, and I'm having the source here right now. This one is, say, for example, S1, and this one is, say, for example, S2. Distance between them is D. Student, screen is being placed. This one is your screen. Screen is placed perpendicular to the line joining the two slits. And small d is very, very lesser than of your capital D. Then what is the path difference? Then the light from this one, what is happening is right now, the light from this source, whatever you are taking, this ray of light, whatever has been going, minus dx, Ruchita. Way better in previous case, minus of your dx part. Have I done anything mistake in this one, beta? Path difference at point B, B to S1 plus S1 to P minus S2 P. Correct, Ashanga? Is there any mistake in this one, beta? come back. Now, chudandi. S1 and S2 are being kept perpendicular to the screen. Now, from this one, the ray of light, whatever I'm taking right now, this will try to go in this one slowly and meet somewhere at your point of your P, this one. Okay, now, in the same way, this is making a small angle with respect to this one. This angle is very small. That is nothing but of your theta. Minus delta into, okay, wait, I'll see it out. Now, from here also, this ray of light will go, interfere, and it will meet somewhere at a point of your P. So, this one is also making a small angle. That is nothing but how much for me were theta. This angle is also your theta. Now, can anyone tell me which is larger distance and which is smaller distance between this one? S2P is a smaller and S1P is of your larger. That means what I need to draw? I need to draw a perpendicular right now on this one like this. This is making an angle of your 90. Local kuda 90 angle right now. So what will be the given condition? The distance from here to here is nothing but of your right now. Okay? This is nothing but of your L. And this L is right now for me very, very greater than of your small d. The distance of your S2 from the screen, whatever I'm taking right now, is your greater than of your small d. Or you can take this one as of your capital D also better. No problem. Depending upon your condition or understanding, that will be your fine for me. Now, can you tell me what is the path difference? This is your path difference. This is nothing but of your delta x. Okay. Now, can anyone tell me what will be the delta x beta? See the figure. So, this one is right now for me D. And here is right now making an angle. So, right now, this one is your path difference. So, this one is making an angle theta here. And this distance is equals to your D. This distance is your D. Isn't it? So wherever is D, that side will be theta. This is your D into your cos theta. And downside, whatever I'm taking, this one will become for me D into your sine theta. The path difference will become for me how much for me? Delta x is equals to S2P minus S1P. That will become here right now D into your cos theta, but not sine theta directly. Okay, now that is an important relation you need to remember. When it is perpendicular, path difference will be equal to how much for me? D into your cos theta. S2P minus S1P, S1P minus S2P. So delta x is S1P minus S2P. That will be equal to D into sine theta part of relation. For bright and dark, again, you can write for the same condition. So if I'm talking about for maxima is nothing but what for me? Bright point. For your bright point, delta x will be equal to how much for me? Your n into your lambda. Nth bright band, whatever if I'm taking. The next one is nothing but of your minima. Minima is nothing but what for me? Your dark point. For your dark point, if I'm taking the relation, delta x is equal to how much for me? 2n minus 1 into your lambda divided by 2. Where theta is nothing but what? Order of fringe. So with the theta, whatever dark band is being formed with increase in theta, I can write here, with increase in theta, the fringe width will be decreasing. Antegada, theta perke kodi ame potundi right now, I'll write here right now, as theta value is increasing, as theta increases, fringe width will be decreasing, So keep this point in your mind. So as the theta is increasing, fringe width will be decreasing. Clear for everyone? So these are the, some of the cases you need to remember in your YDSC when the slots are being incident from above and as well as of your below case. This is again very important conditions which you need to remember for your examination's point of relation. Clear for everyone? Okay, now. Adhamayin dekad varak andar ki? So responsive varga. Yes, take the small question better. Let me see how far have you remembered this one. The favorite. The wavefront of a light beam. The wavefront of a light beam is given by x plus 2y plus 3z is equals to a constant c, okay, where c is some constant. Again, I need not write it again, everything I'll repo it. Okay, so stop, comma, then the angle made by the direction of light with y axis is, he may ask you with y axis, he may ask you with z axis, anything, y axis, x axis or z axis, anything is fine. I'll give you one the answer, the remaining you try to do it on the one. You know the direction of a light is given by what? Direction is represented by n cap. So n cap is equals to I cap plus 2 j cap plus 3 k cap. Ante kada x y z ante, that is nothing but of your direction. Direction is represented by unit vector. You know that angle made by n bar, whatever it may be, angle made by the direction of light, that is nothing but of your n cap. With what? Y-axis. With y-axis is. How do you write this one, beta? Angle cos beta is equals to n cap dot j cap. Y-axis la nadga batti. So that is equals to, how do you write the n cap? N cap is equals to n bar by mod of your n into your j cap. So n bar is equals to how much for mu? N bar is equals to your, how much for mu? For which condition right now? 2. That is nothing but of your n bar along your 2 j cap. That is nothing but 2. Divided by magnitude of this one. That is nothing but of your 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square. That means that will become for me how much? 2 by under root of 3 square is 9. 9 plus 2 that plus 1. That means it will become for me 14. So that will be your answer for me. So he is asking the angle kabatti. So cos beta is equals to 2 by root 14. That means beta is equals to cos inverse of your 2 by root of your 14. So this will be your answer. Okay now. The same way if he is asking for your x-axis and y-axis. I hope you can try that one basically on your own. Can you try it out, beta? Chesara leda? Answer chappare. Is this problem clear for everyone? The wavefront of a light beam is given by x plus 2y plus 3z is equals to constant. The angle made by the direction of light with your y-axis, I have done it. Z-axis and as well as of your x-axis, can you try it or not? Chalo, very good. Okay. Next slide, ready? Lloyd's mirror. Next heading is right now for me. Lloyd's mirror. Chapan starting la gurtunda. There are different types of your sources by which we can produce the interference in the given condition. So next one is nothing but of your Lloyd's mirror. Okay. Let's see. In this one, what you are doing is a plane mirror. A plane mirror or a glass plate. Or a glass plate with reflecting surface. With reflecting surface is illuminated. Is illuminated at almost grazing incident. at almost grazing incident, isn't it? So by one single source, we are trying to produce the two coherent sources. Student, act on the basic condition. I'll try to take the screen here right now. So this one is your screen. Okay, and we are taking a mirror somewhere here right now. So here is your mirror somewhere. Give a minute. This got stuck again somewhere. Sure, I'll take care of itself. Okay, now see here. This one is a mirror, beta. A plain mirror. This one is your screen, okay. And this one is its axis, like this. Okay, somewhere above here we are keeping a source at a certain height from the mirror. Okay. Here is your source, say for example of your S, okay. From this one, the ray of light has been coming. This ray of light will first touch this surface, right, like this. Mirror kabati, incident eye reflect outundi. So it will try to go an incident on this one, like this. Another source of a light will incident on the other extreme end right now, like this. And after reflection right now, for this one, it undergoes the reflection and it will form here right now. Okay, then another ray of light from this one in the middle I'm taking, which falls exactly at the center of this one somewhere here, and this ray of light will get reflect here and it will form here. And then now this is a total region of what? Interference, I can say. And see here right now, listen it very carefully. One ray from this source is directly going like this and reaches at this point, isn't it? So there are different rays, whatever we are taking right now for the given condition. And this source from the mirror is at a height of, say for example, h. Chudandi, the source nunchi one ray of light is going like this, another ray of light is going directly. That means at point P there is an interference. At a point P there is interference of ray of light which is directly going like this. The another ray of light is right now which is going like this, incident at denser medium, and from here it will reflect back and goes here. You know that whenever a ray of light is reflected from that one, it will undergoes your refraction. That means it undergoes a phase difference of your, how much Fermi, your pi by 2. Delta x will be equal to how much Fermi? Pi by 2. I told you yesterday, whenever a ray of light is touching like this and hits this one, and it will change like this. So path difference will become how much for me? Pi by 2. Because it is going from your rarer medium, and this will act as of your denser medium. Now see here, if this ray of light is being extended in the backward direction somewhere here right now, it is meeting somewhere here. This ray of light also, if I extend somewhere here, it is meeting somewhere here. This ray of light also, if I am extending, this is meeting somewhere here right now. That means this is acting as of your right now some S dash. That is nothing but of your virtual source. And the actual one, the false source. endukani this reflected rays of light ni if I am extending them in the backward direction they are meeting somewhere at your s dash. Now this distance from this one is also equal to how much from your same h. That means the distance between the two sources s1 and s is nothing but if a distance between the slits that is nothing but equal to 2 into h. That means from one single parent source I am producing another coherent source which is undergoing the interference part of relation, isn't it? This one is your center of this one right now. Interference is happening in this region. Interference is happening in that region for you basically. Clear for everyone, isn't it? So this is a point of your interference right now. This is a point of your interference. This is nothing but of your P. Clear for everyone? Now the distance of this one from this screen is P to O distance whatever I am taking. That one is say for example some x, isn't it? Clear for everyone? So P to this is nothing but P O and this one is nothing but say for example some P Q. This is Q this one. So P to Q will be the region of P to Q is nothing but what region of interference. Ante kada all the rays are being present only in the region of P to Q. So P to Q is the region of your interference and P is at a distance of x from the O. It is from x from your O and this mirror I am taking it as A and this mirror is nothing but of your B. The distance of this one from this source is nothing but of here to here. This distance is say for example of your capital D. Okay. Now fringe width you already know the formula. Now for the nth bright fringe at your P, I'm writing this right now. For nth bright fringe at P, we use path difference will be equal to how much for me? Path difference delta x is equals to your d into your x divided by capital D plus of your lambda by 2. Isn't it? And that delta x will be equal to how much beta for me? N times of your lambda. N times of your lambda. Ante na? Delta x is equals to bright fringe ki enta? Delta x is equals to how much for me? N into lambda kada? Here n I am represented by capital N into lambda. Don't get confused. So delta x is equal to how much for me? N into your lambda. So therefore I can get the value of your x. X is nothing but what first bright for the x is equals to nth bright will be equal to your. If I simplify that one, that will be 2 into n minus 1 into lambda into capital D divided by your 2 times of your small d. So this is the formula for your nth bright fringe in the lawyer's mirror. The same way, if I am going for your nth dark. For nth dark fringe at P, suppose, so we use delta x will be equal to delta x is equal to how much for me path difference dx by over capital D. Actually manam y iskunam intaku mundu annitki, but here I have taken as x. There is no problem, you can even take dy also, that is not a problem. So this is nothing but of your y by 2. Now for the dark fringe, you know the value of delta x. Delta x is equal to how much for me? 2n plus 1 into your lambda by 2 is equals to d into your x by capital D plus of your lambda by 2. That means x of your n. I need to calculate the value of x. X nth dark will be equal to how much? So if I simplify that one, that is n into lambda into capital D by your small d. So this is the position of your nth dark part of relation. See it everyone right now. Once again the diagram right now. In the Lyot's mirror part of relation, a plane mirror or a glass plate with a reflecting surface is being illuminated. At almost a grazing incidence, the angle which I am using is almost like a grazing incidence part of relation. The distance between the first one is nothing but source. From that source, we are producing a virtual source. Now S and S dash will act as a what? Coherent source. S and S dash will act as coherent source. Coherent source. So it undergoes the interference and meet at your point of your P. So all the rays are taken within the region of your mirror A to B. They are going interference in the region of your P and as well as of your Q. Now distance of the P may be your maxima point or minima point. If it is maxima, what is the condition for maxima? If it is a minima, what is the condition for the minima? Now see the distance between S and S dash is how much? H and H. isn't it? Because mirror, you know that whatever is the distance of an object, image will also form at the same distance. So distance between the two sources, S and S dash, will be equal to how much your mirror? 2 times of your edge. The S dash will act as of your virtual source. And the distance of this slit from the screen is how much for me? Capital D. PQ is the region of your interference. PQ is the region of your interference part of relation. Clear for everyone right now? Now see here. For nth bright fringe at a point P, we can use delta x is equals to your delta x is equals to how much for me? D into small d into your x by your capital D plus lambda by 2. Now tell me why I'm using this plus lambda by 2. Because this white light which I have been taken, that is a reflected ray from the denser medium. So it undergoes a phase difference of your pi by 2. If I'm asking you the fringe width in this one, beta. Fringe width formula. Can anyone tell me the fringe width in this one? Beta is equals to lambda into capital D by your. This will become for me how much? Actual formula is in the manaku. This one is nothing but of your d, small d. So therefore, I can write from this one right now for the given condition. Beta is equals to lambda. There is no change. Capital D, there is no change. But small d is equal to how much from the given figure? Small d is equal to how much for me? 2 times of your h. That means this will become for me 2 into your h. So this is the small change you need to remember in the lawyer's mirror formula. This is only formula based beta. Nothing else is there in this one. So you need to remember the condition and you need to remember the nth bright and as well as of your nth dark condition. And when you're taking plus 1, 2n plus 1 lambda by 2 or 2n minus 1 lambda by 2, make sure that what is the difference between plus and as well as of your minus. That will give you the condition. So I got the condition for your nth bright and as well as of your nth dark condition. So these are the basic conditions you need to remember and these are important formulas. And fringe width for the lawyer's mirror is beta is equals to lambda into capital D by your 2 times of your h. H is nothing but distance between the mirror to source, yes. So total distance is nothing but 2h. So to go through the lawyer's mirror once again, beta. If you are having any doubt, please let me know and I'll try to help you out in that given condition. Yeah. Lawyer's mirror. A plane mirror or a glass plate with reflecting surface is illuminated at almost like a grazing incidence. So from that one, we got the different conditions. See the diagram for everyone. From the source, yes, we are producing a virtual source. That is nothing but of your S dash. The distance between S and S dash is nothing but of your 2H. The distance from the source to screen is nothing but of your capital D. And the interference is happening in the region of your P and as well as of your Q. And P may be the bright point or the dark point. If P is a bright point, you know what to take the value of delta X. And P is a dark point, you know what to take the point of your dark. Now for nth bright fringe at point P, we use delta X is equals to dx by capital D plus lambda by 2. This small point you should keep in mind that why I'm adding here lambda by 2, because the reflected ray from A to P is nothing but undergoing a phase difference of your, how much? Phase difference of your phi. As phi value is equals to pi, we know the relation, delta phi is equals to 2 pi by lambda into delta x. So path difference ento avutundi chudandi intla, the phi value is pi, that is equals to 2 pi by lambda into your delta x. So this pi will get cancelled. So path difference is equals how much for me? Lambda by 2. So that is the reason this extra lambda by 2 we are adding here right now for the path difference. And if it is maxima, use n lambda. And if it is minima, use 2n plus 1 lambda by 2 and simplify it. We'll get the answer for the given condition. Is this clear for everyone? Do you have any doubt in the interference Lloyd's mirror method? Adamin Andarki?
Yes,
sir. Is there any doubt in this one? Is there any doubt in this one? You are martladare. Minanen led kada?
No, sir.
Kada?
Internam, sir.
Name ala response ledu? Adamainda andarki? Malo sir cheppana? Okay. Keep one note better. I hope you already know it, but still for your understanding, I'm writing it out. Fringe width and nana. Fringe width formula beta is equals to lambda into capital D by your small d. That means fringe width is directly proportional to wavelength. The wavelength of light mare kodi manaku fringe width maarutunda. So I can say that fringe width of your red color is greater than the fringe width of your violet color. And then because wavelength of your red color is greater than wavelength of your violet color. Point gurtunda? Okay, the same way in YDSE, if blue light chappandi meeru cheppala, if blue light is used instead of red light, then fringe width emaitadi? Fringe width beta increases or decreases? Chappala, wavelength of your blue is lesser than wavelength of your red, so fringe width will beta will decrease. Ona, next one.
Yes.
If YDSE is conducted in vacuum, is conducted in your vacuum instead of air, then beta value chappandi. Beta value, what happens? Wavelength of your vacuum is greater than wavelength of your air. Idu gurtundi kada andarki? That means fringe width will, what happens? Increases. Fringe width will increase. Fringe width will increase. Okay, now Andy.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sure. Idu kuda. It is very important for your numericals part calculation, beta. If N1 fringes, if N1 fringes are formed when light of wavelength lambda 1 is used, and N2 fringes are formed when light of wavelength lambda 2 is used, then you know the formula, y is equals to n into lambda into capital D by your small d. If this is totally a constant, that means n into lambda is equals to your constant, because capital D is a constant, small d is a constant, even y is remaining constant. Y is equals what I'm taking right now, a constant, then I can write here right now N1 lambda 1 will be equal to your N1 lambda 1 will be equal to how much fermion? N2 lambda 2. Antena? Chappare?
Yes, sir.
Or else I can write N1 beta 1 will be equal to N2 beta 2 and Raicha? Beta is equal to how much for me? Beta is equal to lambda into capital D by your small d, gada. If wavelength is being given, I can write in terms of your fringe widths. N1 by N1 beta 1 will be equal to how much for me? N2 beta 2. Clear for everyone? Sure.
Yes, sir.
This point is also very important.
Yes, sir.
He was under Matratan or in the book. How? This is really very important for your competitive examinations, beta. Very, very important. See, to know maximum number of possible maxima on screen. possible maxima on screen. What we should do? Mallas pakka indi andra bo. I'm writing here itself, you see. D sin theta and then n into lambda, isn't it? So from this one I can write sin theta. Sin theta is equals to n into lambda by your small d. Right, cha? Isn't it? As sin theta value is lesser than or equal to 1. So I can write n lambda by small d must be lesser than or equal to 1. So therefore, how do we calculate the value of n? N must be lesser than or equal to d by lambda. The point at the main under ki. So maximum number of your maxima on a screen and the nana. So maximum number of your complete maxima on screen will be how much beta? 2n plus 1. 2 into n plus 1. Endukani on YDSE, if this is a central maxima, here it is 1 bright, here it is of your 1 bright. So total is how much? 2 plus central bright. Okay na? So it is 2n plus 1 every time for the bright. For maximum number of your complete maxima on the screen means it will be 2n plus of your 1. Is that clear for everyone? So I'm giving you one question as a homework based upon this one. So I will be expecting that you please try to do this one on your own. If you get it, it is very well. If you don't get it, is also very well. I'll help you out in the tomorrow section of your class when you come back. Let me check with the question where it is. Don't know. Yeah. Let me check with one small good question based on this concept. Sure. Write this question better, everyone. Two point sources separated by 2.0 meter are radiating in phase. Radiating in phase with lambda is equals to 0.50 meter. Lambda is equals to 0.50 meter. First off, a detector moves in a circular path around the two sources in a plane containing them. First off, how many maxima are detected? I'll give you the options. First option is 16, second option is 20, third option is 24, And the fourth option is 32. And the diagram for this one is given this one. Vowel sound apne padho gi itla circle ichadu Okay. So this is a screen, a circular screen, distance between S1 and as well as of your S2 is how much for me, what, 2 meters particulation. And here there is some detector and it is moving like this. Okay, this is a given diagram for us. Okay, see the question once again. Anyhow, I'm uploading the recording, so you can see that question from there itself also. Two point sources separated by 2 meters are radiating in phase with wavelength 0.50 meter. Detector moves in a circular path around the two sources in a plane containing them. How many maxima are being detected? So please try to do them. If you're not getting it, please let me know in the tomorrow session of the class. We'll try to continue with this one. Okay, now? Chalo beta, I'm stopping the class right now. Delta x is equals to how much for me? Minus of your dy into d minus d into sine alpha. So simplify that one according to the values. You can substitute and get the answer for that. Okay.